So, yeah, for those who don't know, by the way, if we head here, there's a secret way to another covenant, which I will be joining at some point. Gotta be careful talking to this guy because he has a dialogue choice, and you want to make sure that you hit yes. The game's a cheeky fucker and defaults it to no, and I don't think you can ever rescind that, so yeah. And I don't think he gets out of the way unless you say yes, which is obviously very annoying. Here's Quaylog's sister, and she has a very, very sad, very, very sad backstory, but her placement here is quite convenient for us. There we go. Quite convenient for us because she also happens to be a firekeeper. And of course we have that firekeeper soul. I'm not going to join the covenant just yet. I'm going to stick with the Way of White because the Way of White, Warriors of Sunlight, and Princess Guard are all interconnected, and I think they share like a co-op pool. So you are more likely to see summon signs from those, from members of those three covenants if you yourself are also in one of those covenants. The likelihood of us actually discovering any fucking co-op in this game is basically nil, but you never know. Stranger things have happened. How much damage will I take if I fall down here? Not bad. If this is Dark Souls 2, that would have taken away half my fucking health meter, probably more. Also, you can see the nasty-ass, spiny, tentacly thing from Ceaseless Discharge over there, but we don't need to worry about that. Because, we're not fighting him properly. I've never fought him properly. I don't know why you would. And fuck that shit. I hate that in games like this, when you're playing as a little character and the game is mostly focused on cool one-on-one duel fights, or at the very most, one-on-two duel fights, and then you just have this big, dirty, stationary enemy who just big dumb slam attacks, which always have an AoE with them, because, oh, he shook the ground. You're standing on the ground near where he hit, and it shook, and that takes away half your health, and that's fucking stupid. So, yeah, not a fan of that kind of stuff. Like the old Iron King in Dark Souls 2, who doesn't have a cheeky way to kill him in one hit, unfortunately. But, yeah, the old Iron King sucks. Hate him. Especially because, like, he breathes fire. Yeah, he breathes fire, and you have to run around the side of this wall to avoid the fire. But if you do that too much, he keeps doing it, but it's like, in the time it takes for you to run back around after he's breathed the fire, he starts doing it again, because he recognizes you as being behind the wall, and he's trying to get you from out of the wall. I'm already out of the wall, and stop breathing fire, you cunt! Or then he shoots his big hand laser. Also, look at that face. I mean, look at that fucking face. Does that not just break your heart? Derp! There you go. That killed any tension that might have been there. So, this guy's unfucking believable. But no, seriously, this guy will attack you once you pillage this corpse. Love that phrasing. Once you pillage the corpse, we're also getting a nice shot of hollow ass there. I'll just leave that there for you, so you can appreciate that while I talk. When you pillage this, he will start attacking, and what we're gonna do is run away. You know. Fuck, I was gonna sing that song from Monty Python, the Holy Grail, you know, Robin, brave, brave Sir Robin, but I don't know the words. Bravely ran away, he did. But anyway, that's what we're gonna do, and he's gonna chase us, and he will do something, which you will see, and you hit him a few times, and he dies instantly, in a way that you will see. So, yay, everybody's happy. You can stay around and fight him if, you know, you hate yourself and have rejected pleasure. I'm not quite that far gone yet, so yeah. Anyway, let's pillage this corpse. You get a really cool set from it. Get your fucking Nazgul set. Don't run straight away, though, because he does this. And that's not good. But he's done that, and now we can run past him. And we're gonna fucking leg it and hope to Christ that he doesn't hit us. And if he doesn't, then we will, of course, praise the sun. Maybe. If I feel like... I don't think I have the Praise the Sun emote, which is a goddamn shame. Ooh, that's scary. Get your stamina back, come on. Please. There we go. Oh, I wish I had more. I wish I had a Claranthi ring. I don't even know where it is in this game. I know where it is in Dark Souls 2. And, like, there's three versions of it. You know, Claranthi ring plus one, and then plus two. And a plus two ring is the equivalent to the one in this game. Alright, here we go. Back at the entrance. He's continuing to chase us. I'm gonna two-hand my weapon, just in case. Come along there then, son. He's really desperate to hurt us. as is indicated by what he's going to do next. There we go. And now, we're just going to thwack him. Hello there. And let's just make sure we see him. And he fell. He fell right out of existence, since there's no corpse, and he started fading away. Fading away halfway down. Not even halfway down, pretty much instantly. But now the ceaseless discharge is no longer discharging ceaselessly. The lava dries up. Instantly. Pretty sure that's not how lava works, but what the fuck do I know? Now we're gonna homeward bone back to that fireplace. Fireplace? Bonfire. Which is why we didn't rest at the Fair Ladies. Ooh, 100,000 souls. Isn't that lovely? So, what do we want to level up? Oh, we can level up twice now. Ooh, isn't that exciting? So, of course, we're going to dump two more points into Vitality. Almost said Vigor. There's that Dark Souls 2 kicking in again. Of course, it's called Vigor in Dark Souls 3 as well, I think. But, anyway, what's going to happen now is I'm going to cut away and meet you back up at Firelink Shrine, because nobody wants to see me run all the way up there. So, see you there. Alright, just before we get back to... Just before we get back to Firelink Shrine, just chiming in, since we are going to the catacombs next, and if you're deciding to do it early game, I recommend coming here, because one of those two items is the Astora Straight Sword, which, in the catacombs, for those who don't know, there are necromancers who will revive any skeletons that you kill. The Astora Straight Sword kills them permanently without the need to kill the necromancers. I mean, obviously, you're going to want to kill the necromancers anyway, and the necromancers don't respawn. But it at least gives you a bit of a breathing space as you wipe out the skeletons to get to the necromancers. Also, we can take this item here, and it won't wake up the dragon. Going in there will wake up the dragon. You can grab the Astora Straight Sword without waking him up, but it's... Yeah, you gotta be careful, put it that way. It can be a bit finicky. The other item is a shield, the Dragon Crest Shield, I believe. So, yeah, it's pretty worthwhile to come down here if you've got the Master Key early to get those items, especially if you're going to the catacombs. Anyway, cutting away until we get back up to Firelink Shrine again. Okay, and here we are. Before we delve down into the catacombs, I would just like to reverse my hollowing, because why the fuck not? Well, actually, that's not entirely true. I might summon Paladin Leroy. Might, being the operative word, depends on how I feel. I mean, I won't need to, but it might be nice to. Hi, Laurentius! And of course, Griggs is also here. But we don't need to talk to either of those guys, so fuck 'em. Now, I never did finish my story about the Pursuer, did I? I don't believe so. I got interrupted while fighting Quaalog. You know, concentrating on the giant spider centaur, which breathes lava. You know, that tends to take priority over everything else in your mind. But anyway, I didn't get to use the power stance on him because I wasn't leveled up enough, of course. I mean, it's right there at the start of the game. Having said that, you can go to Hades Tower of Flame before you go to the Forest of the Lost Giants, so... But anyway... Huh? You stupid twat. Oh shit. Don't want to then die in the same way. That would make me look like quite the fool. Ah, you cunt! Oh god, it takes so many hits to kill these guys. That's okay, because if all goes well, I'll be skipping most of the deaths. Emphasis on if all goes well. Let's see how we... Oh, that's not bad, actually. I mean, you gotta make sure you're in the clear before you use that attack, and I got interrupted again from my story, but I'm kind of dealing with some shit here. I think those guys are continuing to respawn. There's a necromancer nearby, and obviously we want to deal with him. Ow, you fucking cunt. Oh god, oh god. I really don't like the Gold Tracer. The Gold Tracer sucks a fucking dick! Could someone please explain to me why every second swing was fucking missing him? Anyway, you may be wondering why on the way down here I would have had to use 3 Estus flasks. That's assuming, of course, I didn't leave the footage in. In which case, the reason is because the gold tracer is a piece of shit. Oh, that weapon. Does not do enough damage. And the fact that it locks you into those animations. I'm actually going to leave the Ring of Fog on for a little bit. Just, give myself some breathing space and I'll deal with you. Since you won't be able to follow me anyway, there's no point in leaving any loose ends behind. And I still didn't finish talking about the pursuer. So, I believe in my right hand my character had a dagger and in my left had the fire longsword. That might have been the case, it might have been 2 swords, I'm not quite sure. Either way, I ended up having to two-hand the fire longsword, which as I said was in my left hand, and the controls do change, but that's fine, it's not confusing for me at all, I don't have any issue with it. But as a left-handed person, seeing my character go full left-handed on a motherfucker and kill him that way gave me immense satisfaction. So, yeah. It took a while to kill the fucker. Okay, please let this work, please let this work. Oh god, no, wait, shit, I don't remember which way I'm supposed to go down. Fuck. I'm getting scared now. I'm lost, I'm alone and scared. No, I'm not supposed to land on there, because that's got spikes on it, you fucking dumbass. I've actually forgotten where I'm supposed to jump down. Come on, guys, jump off. There we go. You stupid bastards. There is a way you're able to drop down. And you skip, like, most of the level. It's fucking wonderful. But, having a little trouble locating it for some reason. Which is strange, because it is easy enough. It's supposed to be easy enough to see. Maybe I'm supposed to jump there. Yeah, that might be it. But what if my head boops off that wall there and it messes with me? You know how jumping is in these Souls games, it's kind of shit. Well, we're gonna give her a go. The bonfire, almost called it a fireplace again. That is exactly what happened. So that's great. Thanks, platforming. Thanks a whole bunch. Okay, perhaps we're not gonna be skipping a whole load of stuff. That's a terrible tragedy, you fucking dick. Please be too far away for the necromancer. I didn't get any souls, so obviously he wasn't. That's great. Guys, just thank you. See, I remember dropping... Oh god, are they both gonna fall off again like Riddy? There, like Riddies? Like retards? Perhaps one shouldn't criticize someone as a retard when one apparently can't even speak one's own language. I know I've dropped off here before. I did it in the preparation run at some point. I just dropped off and... Oh, there it is! Fucking dumbass. Alright, let's do this. Oh, that's fucking terrifying how much damage that does. But it's okay. It's okay because... Well... Oh shit, reverse my hollowing. I didn't reverse my hollowing, which means I can't summon Paladin Leroy. I mean, it's not a problem. I mean, Pinwheel's a piece of piss. But, you know, it's just nice to have him. You know, for the sake of company. For the sake of a bit of fun. Now, if there are any new players watching, they might think to themselves, well, you know, this whole, perhaps wanting to show some things off for new players is kind of a... Kind of pointless if you're skipping a whole area, isn't it? But, well, look at it this way. I've just showed you how to skip the catacombs. So, that's got to count for something. Okay, wait until they're doing their attack. Please? Hello? Well, fuck you two, then. Don't do me any bloody favors. Oh, Jesus. I hate these guys. They're, like, probably my least favorite enemy in the whole game. Cunts. Cunts is what they are. It doesn't help that in the painted world of Ariamis, there's more of them, and they're in tight fucking quarters. Like a very narrow sort of sewer way. That's a major pain in the behooliks. That was a weird, grunty sort of thing there. Anyway, let's do some damage. It's not bad, you know. It's not great, but it's not bad. I forgot the power within, but I mean, it's fucking Pinwheel. This ain't gonna be a problem. Actually, how much damage will the Gold Tracer do? Will you let me down as usual? Not really. Wait, what the? Cheeky little fucker. Now one might ask why I wasted time even attacking one of the fake ones, and the answer to that, of course, is I don't really know. Don't stand in front of him. I mean, he's a bitch, but perhaps he's a glass cannon. We're not. We're not a glass cannon. We're just weak in every fucking respect. So, that's awesome. That's not an explosion. AoE. It looks like it's going to be, but it's not. Oh, hello. Could the real Pinwheel please stand up? Well, it doesn't matter if he's standing or not, because he's fucking dead. So, I wonder which mask we got. Alright. Now, gonna homeward bone out. Level up again. I think it costs 50,000 souls to level up now, or something ridiculous like that. Yes, it does. So, more vitality. Can't go wrong with more health. And like before, I'm gonna cut back to when I get the Firelink Shrine. So that's gonna be a lot of fucking editing for me in this. But, never mind. It's not that big of a problem, really. It's just one of those things you complain about, but really it's not that bad. So, yeah, see you back at Firelink Shrine. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. I spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. See me running through that open door. I believe I can fly. Okay, and we're back at Firelink Shrine. Reverse our hollowing, because why not, right? And we have one more bit of preparation before Sen's Fortress. We don't technically have to do it. All it's going to achieve is allowing us access into an optional area. But I plan to play that optional area, so obviously I would like to get access to it. And we will take... Actually, I'm just going to take this, just for the sake of curiosity. We're going to be heading back to the asylum, and thus fighting the stray demon, and obviously we won't be parrying him. Oh. Oh, I guess Petrus went with the other NPCs down into the Tomb of the Giants. Huh. Have fun with that. Tomb of the Giants fucking sucks. I'd love to know how they get back. Maybe they just homeward bone. Maybe they've got their own Lord Vessel. I think the fuckers would share. Or, you know, they just walked. I mean, there's that. Okay, now this jump is really weird, because it's like you can't do it in 60 frames per second, but the thing is, when you're doing it in 30, you're not actually jumping, you're just rolling. I mean, that's all you do, you just roll. And you reach it, but the roll doesn't reach in 60 frames per second, because I've tried. Maybe the jump will work? But if I fuck it up, I have to run all the way back over and do more editing. Which I just admitted isn't actually that big of a problem, so I don't get to use that excuse. Alright, fuck it, let's... What we're gonna do is... Okay, hold the button down. Oh, no, we made it. But now we can't actually run up the hill. Oh, no. Yay! I made all the shit without having to turn off my precious 60 frames. Isn't that lovely? Makes me happy. Saves me having to reach over to the keyboard and hit the backspace key, because, ooh, that's a very arduous task right there. I don't know if I should be doing that. Might stress my fingers. Anyway, we need this. And now we get to do that jump again! So that's... yay. Anyway. I'm not editing that, fuck off. Mainly because we're right here. Okay, and... we'll be heading back to the asylum, fighting the stray demon. I've got the rusted iron ring, so obviously I don't technically need to show how to get it, but I'm going to anyway, because I believe I promised I would earlier. Nope, nope, nope!